Customers tell us they want to buy our merchandise by sending us a sales order. A sales order is a document that the customer sends us to formally request the merchandise. This means that it's a document that asks us to ship the merchandise to the customer. A sales order is very simple to make. A sales order is like any other document in QuickBooks. A sales order represents an event that must be recorded. If the customer formally requests merchandise, that's a financial event that must be recorded in your QuickBooks records. However, a sales order is not a transaction. Because it is not a transaction, recording a sales order will not show up in the journal. It will not show up in the accounts and the trial balance, and it will have no effect in your general ledger chart of accounts. Sales orders have their own separate reports that help you manage which ones have been filled and which ones are waiting to be filled. An open sales order is a sales order that we have received from the customer but not yet shipped out to the customer. The best report to see all open sales orders is the open sales orders by item report. From the main menu, click Reports, Sales, Open Sales Orders by Item. Notice All has already been chosen in the date pull-down choice, and it has a column for everything you need to manage your sales orders regarding quantity, invoice, back-ordered, and so on. To see this clearly, we will record these three sales order. June 10, Alan ordered 15 apples. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Sales Orders. June 10th, customer is Alan Arby, 15 apples. The item is apples and the quantity is 15. Push Tab to save the field, that's $750, save and new. And the next order is June 11th. Betty ordered 35 bananas. So we go Betty Boop, June 11th, bananas, quantity 35. Save and new. And the last sales order we enter will be June 12th. Alan ordered 95 bananas. So, June 12, Alan Arby, bananas, 95. Push Tab. On the last one, we click Save and Close, and this is what it looks like in the Open Sales Order by Item report. Notice it has the quantity of each sales order. It shows how many we invoiced, how many we sent a bill for, which we have none, and how many were back ordered. When we ship the merchandise to the customer, we send the customer an invoice with the merchandise. This will remind the customer to pay. Let us imagine that we shipped out some of those sales orders, so please record these two invoices. June 13th, we shipped the 15 apples to Alan from sales order number 1. Let's record the invoice. Customers, create invoice. June 13th, notice what happens at the moment we choose customer Alan. QuickBooks knows we have open sales orders for Alan, so if we put his name on an invoice, QuickBooks asks us to choose which open sales order we are filling. We are filling number 1, so we click in the row of number 1. When we click OK, QuickBooks asks us, are we putting all of the products and merchandise that were on the sales order onto this invoice? Or are we only putting some of the merchandise that Alan ordered onto this invoice? In this case, we are shipping out all of order number 1. So since this invoice will match the sales order exactly, we choose the top choice, create invoice for all of the sales order. When we click OK, all of the information from sales order number 1 has been put into invoice number 34. We don't have to do anything but choose the date and the customer. When we click Save and Close, we can take a look now at the open sales order by item, and we notice that order number 1 has disappeared from the open sales order report because it is no longer an open sales order. Let us now imagine on June 14th, we shipped only 5 of the 35 bananas to Betty from order number 2. Let's take a look. Customers, create invoice, choose June 14th. At the moment we choose Betty, QuickBooks knows there's an open sales order for Betty. Since there's only 1, we can only choose this one. We click in the row and the check mark goes into the margin. Now when we click OK, QuickBooks is asking us, will all of the items on the sales order go into the invoice or only some of the items? We will click Create Invoice for Selected Items, click OK, and here we have only bananas, but the ordered here is 35. To invoice is the amount that we are physically shipping out. So we are invoicing 5 out of the 35 that are ordered, and this is the field that you change. When we click OK, QuickBooks only invoices for 5 of these bananas, making a sales price of $500, and the other 30 are clearly stated to the customer as on back order. Now when we click Save and Close, we can look at the open sales order by item, and we can see invoiced 5, back ordered 30 for sales order number 2.